Hey everyone, welcome to the semicolon. In this tutorial, we'll be implementing a convolutional neural network using Keras with TensorFlow's backend. We'll use the MNIST Handwritten Digit dataset to build a digit classifier. If you do not know what a convolutional neural network is or have any questions in the functioning of it, watch the video about working of convolutional neural network, and that should give you a basic idea of convolutional neural network, and then we can start. So this channel also has lots of videos on machine learning, and you might want to subscribe for that because I have new videos coming up. So let's get started with implementation. We had run random forest algorithm on the same data set, and that gave us around 96% accuracy. So let's see what convolutional neural networks offer us here. I import the libraries sequential model from Keras models. Also, we need to import dense, dropout, activation, and flatten from Keras layers. I'll explain you what each of them mean as we use them. For the convolutional layer, let's also import convolution 2D, and for MaxPooling layer, let's import MaxPooling 2D. So to validate our model, we'll be needing test train split. So I'll be using the one from the scikit-learn because I'm very comfortable in it. Otherwise, Keras has a utility to do the same function. We need to import pandas and numpy as well. The data is available in CSV, and I'll import it using pandas. So this is our data, this is what it looks like, and we'll have to modify it a bit to be able to feed it into our convnets. So for now, all the pixels are arranged as rows, and we need an image to be represented as a matrix to work on it. So let's reshape the image, the array, using the reshape function. So I reshape it to 28 cross 28 cross 1, and 28 is height, 28 is width, and 1 represents channel. In the RGB color images, we can have 28 plus 28 cross 3, but we have black and white images here, so it's 28 cross 28 cross 1. So I create two lists. One is to store the images, and the other one is to store the labels. Say, if the first element of df underscore x contains the pixel array for image representing, say, number 4, then the first element of y would contain 4. So that is why we have two lists, one to store the pixel arrays and other to store the labels. So now let me go ahead and pull all the pixels into the list, converting them into arrays. And let's store the labels too. Now the problem we are looking here is classification problem, because we have the digits and we have to classify them into 10 classes, 1 to 10, 0 to 9 actually. So we need our labels or results to be categorical. Currently, they are represented as 1, 2, 3, and so on. And this is a problem for us. And why is it a problem? Because firstly, labels 1, 2, 3, and so on signify a relationship. Say 2 times 1 is 2. So which is not something we want our model to infer. And we are only interested in identifying the digits in this problem. And we know that it can only be recognized by its shape. So shape of 1 representing value 1 is independent of shape of 2 representing value 2. So that is why we don't need any relationship among themselves. And that is why we have to make it categorical. And how does making it categorical solve the problem? So when we make it categorical, we make different columns for each digit. And then the digits, which is the label, would have value 1, and all other digits would have value 0. So for example, 0 will have vector 1 and 9 zeros, and 1 will have 0, 1, and then 8 zeros following it. So that is how these vectors are orthogonal, and they have no relationship among themselves. So Keras has a two categorical function which takes in our labels and the number of classes and transform it to categorical labels. And once we are done, let's convert everything to the numpy arrays and check the shape. And the shapes are good. Then we split into test and train, and we're done with pre-processing our data for feeding it into CNNs or convolutional neural network. Now let's start implementing the main part, which is our model. Let's start implementing our convolutional neural network model using Keras. And we need a sequential model, so we start a sequential model by typing model equal to sequential. And before we add any layer, let's define our architecture first. We'll then need to test it out and make changes in it for improvements in accuracy. So we need a convolutional layer which will take 28 plus 28 images as input. And let the convolutional layer have 32 filters, each of size 3 plus 3. And let's take activation as ReLU so that we won't need to add normalization layer separately. And let's add MaxPooling layer of size 2 plus 2 and then flatten it up into a neural network. And let the next layer of the neural network have 100 nodes, and the output layer of the neural network, let it have 10 nodes, since we have converted our labels to categorical labels. So let's start by typing model.add convolution2d, then write the number of filters, which is 32, and the size of filters, which is 3, and we'll just have to write it once because we want 3 cross 3, and length and width are same, so we need to write it just once. The data format needs to be channel last, since we've rearranged our images to be 28 cross 28 cross 1. And activation is ReLU, as we've discussed. And for the first convolution layer, we'll need to give it the input shape. So our input shape is 28 cross 28 cross 1. And the one at the end is the channel. And we have to add it because Keras needs it like that. So we add it. Otherwise, 28 cross 28 would be sufficient. And after this, let's add a MaxPooling 2D layer of pool size 2 cross 2, and then we flatten the array so that we get a fully connected network. And let the next layer have 200 nodes by typing dense. So dense is a neural network, and what flatten does is it converts all our matrix to a single vector. So we'll have all those nodes in a neural network. And then let the output layer have 10 nodes, since we need 10 outputs. And in the middle, we add dropout, as it helps us in avoiding overfitting. The dropout drops out 50% of the weights in the learning process when we drop out 0.5. Then we compile it with loss function, categorical cross entropy. Now loss function is something which will calculate the errors in the prediction. And choosing which loss function to use is a huge research area in itself, and we'll look into it later. The optimizer is something which learns the weights, and that is adder delta for now. We can also look which one to choose later on. And while learning, we need to see our accuracy. So in metrics, I specify accuracy. Typing model.summary gives me the summary of model, where we can confirm the input and output shapes. So input, we are taking 28 cross 28 images, and output we are getting 26 cross 26 because 3 cross 3 filters and the borders are zeros. So we get 26 cross 26, and we have 32 filters, so we get 26 cross 26 cross 32 size matrix. And then when we flatten it, we get a huge number of nodes, and then 100 nodes, and then 10 nodes. So that is our model, and we've checked it. And now let's train the model. I use model.fit and pass the training data. And for validation, I pass test data. Let's first train the model with just 100 images and check if it's any good. So I run this, and the accuracy seems to be very poor. And what have we missed? Pause it and think about it for a second, because I've figured out what we've missed. So the problem at hand is a classification problem. And we need the output to be probabilities of the digits. And to do that, we'll have to use a softmax activation. And we haven't done that. Now just look at the power of this activation function and how much it can affect the accuracy. So I apply the softmax activation and train the model again and look at the result with just 100 digits. Because there has been an improvement, let's train it on the full data. And this will take around 10 minutes on my slow old laptop. And if you're gonna do a lot of machine learning stuff, especially deep learning stuff, then you better buy a machine with NVIDIA GPU. You can check out some of them in description below. And alternative solutions would be using AWS or Google Cloud Services, because you won't be able to use your laptop till this thing is complete. So as this goes on, I want you to have a look at loss and the accuracy. Now, if you observe loss, it is continuously falling. And ideally, we need to run the model till the loss doesn't change anymore. That is one of the oldest rules in machine learning. Also, as the loss decreases, the accuracy keep on increasing. So the loss drops, looks like the accuracy is almost 97% to 98%, which is pretty nice, and which is better than the random forest. Now we can tweak a few things in the model, like the activations, like the number of filters, or the number of layers, the number of convolution layers, or the order of layers, anything. That is how we are going to tweak and improve our accuracy. You can use model.predict for predictions and model.evaluate for loss and accuracy values. Some key points to note is the model has around 500,000 training parameters, which may overfit very easily because of the high number of parameters. So be careful with that by adding dropouts or using appropriate activations whenever possible. Also, proper activations and loss functions can help improve the accuracy by a lot, and that is where you need to spend your time on. So that is it. We have successfully implemented our convolutional network, which classifies handwritten digits up to around 97% of accuracy. Now you can go ahead and win your $1 million competition on Kaggle. Thank you.